Well, Jonah, you won't be using that anymore to wash your car.
No, this bucket's held its last gallon of water, Danny. I'm going to be using this one to store my electrical cord. What I've done is I've drilled a 1.5-inch diameter hole with a hole saw, and I'm going to feed the male end of the cord through the hole. When you drill this hole, you have to make sure that it's large enough to take the end of the cord. Usually 1.5 to 2-inch diameter hole is plenty. You just pull out a foot or so, and you dump the rest of the cord in the bucket. Then next time you need to work, you just carry this over and plug in one end and carry out the cord.
Now this is, what, a 50-foot cord. You have plenty of room. Could you use, what, 150-foot?
You could probably fit a 200-foot cord here. You see there's plenty of room. This is a 5-gallon bucket. You even have room to put in any tools that you might be using on the job.
But now I understand it's not a good idea to use a cord, an electrical cord, coiled up like that.
Right. You can store it like this, but when it comes time to use the cord, manufacturers do recommend that you pull the cord out. They're afraid that the insulation will melt if the heat gets built up, and it could short out the cord.
Okay, well, this is a great idea. You know, if you're doing a project around your home and you have all your tools in your shop and you can put them right in this bucket, carry them right inside, and you're not having to run back and forth. So it's a great storage idea and a good way to keep your cord all in one nice, neat place. Yet another way to use a 5-gallon bucket.